Today, I'm very excited to test something I've never tried before, and I've been waiting for this opportunity for a long time. The ComMarker Omni One. It is a UV, galvo-style laser engraver. Unlike the infrared or blue lasers I've tested so far, this laser emits ultraviolet light. UV light is absorbed by a wide range of materials, meaning a UV laser can engrave almost anything, including metals, plastics, leather, wood, and, most importantly, glass. In this video, I'll put the machine to the test by engraving various materials to explore the practical applications of a UV laser engraver. Since ultraviolet light is highly absorbed in most materials, UV lasers don't need much power. Most UV lasers range from 3 to 10 watts, and these types of lasers are usually quite expensive, with 10-watt models selling for over $10,000. They often require an additional water chiller as well. However, the ComMarker Omni is a compact 5-watt air-cooled machine, and it's one of the most affordable 5-watt UV laser engravers on the market today. Despite its low power, the machine is neither slow nor weak. It engraves at lightning-fast speed, and thanks to UV light's efficient absorption, it causes minimal heat damage and warping to metals and plastics. Unlike fiber lasers, which engrave by heat, UV lasers alter surfaces by breaking chemical bonds. Combining this with its incredibly small laser spot size, a UV laser can produce highly detailed crisp engravings on wood and similar materials, as well as engrave and cut materials that no other laser type can handle. Now, let's take a quick look around the ComMarker Omni before we evaluate its performance by testing various materials. Compared to the ComMarker B6, the Omni is a much larger machine. With the machine, you receive safety goggles, a foot pedal, a ruler, a lifting table, 150 and 70 millimeter lenses, and other essentials. It can be operated using either EasyCAD or LightBurn. The air-cooled UV laser generator is mounted on top and connected to the galvo head. The galvo head contains two mirrors that can move extremely fast and precise, and are used to direct the laser beam on the surface. At the back, you'll find connections for the rotary attachment, enclosure, foot pedal, and the Z-axis column. After turning on the machine, you also need to activate the laser source, which takes about a minute to heat up to operating temperature. Once it's ready, the button stops flashing, and a blue dot appears on the surface. The galvo head has two laser pointers for focusing. The machine can be focused manually or electrically. It's in focus when the two red dots align, or you can measure the correct distance with a ruler. I made this easier by creating a simple focus stick that I use to measure the distance. When the machine is perfectly focused, the engraving noise is loudest when using a powerful setting. Regarding the power setting, UV lasers don't have a traditional power setting. Engraving power is controlled by the frequency and the Q pulse parameter. The smaller the Q pulse, the stronger the engraving effect. And with a higher frequency, more pulses are emitted within a given time. Another thing to mention is that UV light is not visible to human eye. But on most materials, you can see the preview due to the fluorescence. For previewing the engraving location on materials that don't have fluorescent properties, you sometimes need to use a paper sheet, or translucent acrylic, or a yellow marker to make the beam visible. But many materials allow for previewing without that. Now let's do some tests to see what this machine is capable of. I used 150mm lens for all tests, unless otherwise noted. First, I will test the ComMarker Omni on plastics, as this is the material where UV lasers feel right at home. I tested it on black acrylic by engraving a simple test pattern which varies frequency and Q pulse. On black acrylic, a nice white engraving with great contrast can be produced. Engravings on black acrylic are similar to the one which can be made with infrared fiber lasers, but the UV laser produces shallower engravings which don't stick out that much. Where UV laser especially shines is at photo engravings, as its laser spot size is way smaller than that of the fiber lasers. The level of detail is incredible. I also tried engraving blue and yellow acrylic, which I had on hand, and it also produced good results. Fiber lasers were not as successful engraving these colors. UV laser works very well on translucent acrylic too. It produces a very good white engraving effect. Next, I tried engraving various spray bottle plastic caps I had laying around. It produced good results on all of them. The translucent white cap produced a various range of deep and shallow engraving effects. The opaque white has produced various shades of gray with varying depth. And the black cap produced white markings. I also tried it on polyethylene plastic, and it produced fantastic results. Markings are smooth and undetectable by touch. A bit less success I had with engraving transparent acrylic. The UV laser beam went right through and engraved the material below. Acrylic comes in two types, extruded and cast acrylic. I think mine is extruded, and I think that the cast acrylic is much better for engraving. People had great success engraving transparent acrylic with UV lasers. I tried a different piece of acrylic, and the result was a bit better, but still not the best. Here I have a random electronic product which already has laser markings on it done by the factory. The ComMarker Omni can reproduce the exact same quality of markings which are indistinguishable from factory ones. This is because the exact same type of laser is used for making these markings on majority of plastic products. You can mark plastic bottles too. Here is a translucent gray plastic water bottle, and the ComMarker was able to produce very high quality white mark that looks as if it was printed on. But it is much more durable than the print and cannot be sanded off. Another cool way of using an UV laser is marking your tools so people don't steal them. You can produce incredibly detailed permanent markings on plastic and metal tools. Speaking of metals, I think it's time to see what this machine can do with different types of metals. Metal business cards are very easy to engrave, as you can get great results with a wide range of settings. Raw aluminum also engraves very well with a UV laser, although it produces shallower engravings than a fiber laser. Copper, brass, and other similar metals also produce great results, although you can't make the engravings as deep as with fiber laser. UV laser also works very well on stainless steel. You can engrave thinner sheets since it produces less heat, and the metal is not warping as much as with fiber lasers. The ComMarker Omni produces durable white engravings on anodized aluminum, similar to fiber lasers. But due to having a much smaller laser spot size, even more details can be achieved. I engraved a test pattern on a piece of scrap anodized aluminum to measure its laser spot size. Looking at the interval scale, we can see that the laser spot size is approximately 0.04 millimeters, which is incredibly small for a 150 millimeter area lens. And small text engraving test has shown that it can engrave incredibly small text with amazing details despite the high speed that was used to engrave it. I think 0.1 millimeter tall text would still be possible to engrave clearly. At higher speeds, the machine ran out of power and usable frequency range as the engraving became dotted and pale. But this is incredibly fast speed for such detailed work. I repeated the test using the included 70 millimeter lens, which should achieve even smaller laser spot size. Looking under a microscope, we can see that with the 70 millimeter lens, the laser spot size is approximately 20 microns thick. This means that with the smaller lens, much more power density can be achieved. But the downside of the smaller lens is a much shallower depth of focus, and just a small variation of height will cause issues. The next material we'll be testing is glass. UV light is absorbed by glass, allowing you to engrave it directly with the ComMarker Omni. A UV laser is the only type of laser that can directly ablate glass. Other lasers simply heat the surface until small cracks are formed. The result is a perfectly clear engraving, indistinguishable from sandblasting. For comparison, this pickle jar was engraved using a diode laser and black paint, while this logo was created with a fiber laser and black transfer foil, which caused the glass to crack due to the heat. Here is a flask engraved with a CO2 laser, which leaves an even rougher surface. The results from the UV laser are noticeably superior. I engraved some test patterns on a piece of tempered glass that was once part of a document scanner. Interestingly, I noticed that certain settings produced engravings at varying depths within the glass. Some parts appear to be etched on a deeper level than others. Using the same settings, I created one engraving on the surface and another within the middle of the glass. They truly are at different levels. When I shine a light from above, both squares cast shadows on the paper below, but if I flip the glass, the surface engraving no longer casts a shadow, while the other one still does, indicating it's actually embedded within the glass. I repeated this experiment on a thinner piece of glass, and this time, one engraving was made on the top surface and the other was on the bottom. It's a fascinating phenomenon. If anyone has an explanation, please leave a comment below. Since this machine can directly ablate glass, I wanted to see if it could cut it. I ran 10 passes over the logo to create a deep engraving and 50 passes for the cutout. I can't believe it actually managed to cut through. It produced a beautiful piece. The edge has a slight angle, which is common with galvo lasers, but this can be minimized by adjusting settings and readjusting the focus height midway through. But it still blows my mind. This is so cool. Next, I tried engraving wood. The UV laser works beautifully with wood, creating incredibly crisp engravings without any smoke stains. I ran a few more passes to add some depth, and the result was a picture-perfect deep engraving with zero smoke stains and stunning detail. I'm incredibly impressed. To test the precision further, I engraved a regular toothpick. Although the UV light preview is less visible, it's remarkably accurate as the lines are extremely thin. Can you make out the engraving? Let's take a closer look under the microscope. I can't believe how sharp the engraving looks, especially given how quickly it was completed. And this was achieved with the larger 150mm lens. Leave a like and subscribe if you'd like to see more laser-related content. This machine is excellent for engraving different types of fabrics. Because it's gentle and produces little heat, it can easily remove color from the surface of dyed fabrics like denim. The UV laser ablates the dye while leaving the fabric fibers intact, preserving the fabric's strength. For comparison, the two engravings at the bottom were made with a diode laser, which created darker engravings but reduced the fabric's strength due to the heat. UV lasers are commonly used to create artificial wear patterns on jeans. I also engraved a black hat with great success. Thin felt, like this piece, is perfect for making Christmas decorations or similar items, as it can be engraved and cut very quickly. I also tested a polyester sports towel. Since polyester fabrics aren't dyed like traditional fabrics, the laser darkens the material and removes the fine fluff on top. The result looks great, with no damage to the towel's structure, allowing it to retain its durability. This is a fantastic way to create customized gifts, and I'm very pleased with the results. Next, I wanted to determine the usable focus range depth with the 150mm lens. First, I engraved my logo directly onto a plastic bottle, and then I used cylinder correction in light burn to demonstrate how easily you can correct cylinder distortion without using a rotary tool. Comparing the two results, the difference is striking. This also shows that the 150mm lens has a very wide usable focus range. UV laser can also be used to remove paint from drink cans. For the first engraving, the settings were adjusted to remove only the paint, revealing the bare aluminum underneath. The second engraving used higher power, which also marked the aluminum, creating a white frosted look similar to what I achieved with a fiber laser in a previous video. The UV laser is also highly effective on ceramic cups. It completely removes the paint, exposing the shiny ceramic surface below and producing a crisp white engraving. For comparison, the engraving above was done with an infrared fiber laser in one of my previous videos. Despite having only 5 watts, the ComMarker Omni can cut materials that other lasers can't handle. Here, I'm cutting 2 millimeter thick high-temperature gaskets used for exhaust manifolds, and the machine cuts through them in just 10 passes using a wobble setting. The gaskets turned out perfect. For comparison, here I did a test with a fiber laser and a CO2 laser, both of which were unable to cut through even at slower speeds, and a blue diode laser didn't work either. The UV laser also excels at engraving faux leather on notebooks, producing results far superior to those I previously tried with a fiber laser. Paper can also be easily engraved with the ComMarker Omni. And of course, you can engrave cardboard too. As it doesn't burn the surface, it is easy to make customized gift boxes or awesome packaging for your products. Slate stone also produces great results. The color is slightly different compared to other lasers which have more power, but this can be fixed by running multiple passes. ComMarker Omni also produces great results on leather. Since it works with low heat, it doesn't produce burn marks. It can also cut the leather if it is not too thick. Another cool thing you can do is to engrave dried leaves. This method shows how delicate and precise this laser can be. The laser beam removes the leaf's surface and leaves the underlying structure of the leaf untouched, producing a cool effect when shining a light through it. The ComMarker Omni is one of the most affordable 5-watt UV laser engravers available. A 5-watt UV laser is surprisingly versatile, able to engrave nearly all materials, which is what no other type of laser can do. With it, you can engrave and cut plastics, metals, rubber, leather, paper, wood, glass, and more. Plus, it generates very little heat, which prevents thin metals or plastics from melting and leaves no smoke stains on wood, a feature unique to UV lasers. This machine is an excellent choice if you want a simple, versatile device that can handle almost everything. However, if you're more interested in making fast or deep engravings in metal or stone, or need a wider range of engraving effects on metals, a fiber laser like the ComMarker B4 or B6, which I've previously reviewed, may be worth considering. But note that fiber lasers aren't suited for engraving wood or glass, and aren't as effective on plastics,